Are you thinking about relocating to Brampton, Ontario, but are not sure what the best time is, what services are available to you, or what you need to set up in this whole process? Well, this video is for you. I'm going to be going over the top tips of what you need to do when you are relocating to Brampton, Ontario. By the way, my name is Amira Dunnett and I'm a local real estate agent right here in the GTA and I am with eXp Realty. And if you have any questions about relocating to this beautiful city, Brampton, Ontario, please go ahead and reach out to me. All of my contact information is right there in the description for you. I have lived in this city for over 30 years. Oh gosh. I'm just telling you guys my age. That's okay. Please go ahead and reach out to me. I am here to help. This city is my home. So if you have any questions at all, you know what to do. Reach out to me. All of my contact information is right there in the description. All right, let's dive right in. When is the best time to move? For a smooth relocation, timing is everything. And mostly it falls under your circumstances. But if you're really thinking about whether and when to move, we say it's usually the spring or the summer. In the spring and the summer, you've got some great weather to go out and explore your new area. You're not battling some cold temperatures or some snow on the floor. So this is one of the best times to move. Now, I also say the spring is a great option because you would be buying or looking for a rental in the wintertime. I know that sounds kind of crappy, but there are not a lot of buyers out there during that time, which means properties are on the market a little bit longer, which gives you an opportunity to find something that fits you. Especially with us being in a buyer's market right now when it comes to purchasing, you have an upper hand, especially into winter, because you are not fighting a lot of buyers out there, and you might find something that fits you perfectly, and then you would just pick a closing date that was in the spring, so you wouldn't actually be moving in the winter. But again, look at your situation, what timeline works for you. You're trying to plan for your future, so see what works and then try to decide that way. Now, what essential services do you have to set up? Number one, you want to set up your utilities. That's water, gas, and hydro. Now, so many companies have made it super easy to set this up online. You just have to go on their website, literally select I am moving, and then put in your name and your new address, and they will literally transfer everything over for you. Also, don't forget to set up insurance. If you're a tenant, you need tenant insurance. And if you're purchasing, you need home insurance. All of these things you want to set up about a week or two prior to your actual move so that when you get into your home, everything is already set up, ready to go. Also, you want to set up your internet. We all use our internet always 24/7. You don't want to move into your house and be like, uh-oh, I didn't set up my internet. Wait, I work Monday from home and I need my internet. So don't forget to set that up either. Next, you want to see what local resources are there for newcomers. I know coming to a new city is super overwhelming, can be very stressful, and that's why I'm making this video to try to make it not so stressful. But you really want to find out what resources are available for you. One of the websites that I think is amazing is immigrationpeel.ca. This website has so many resources for you to be able to click through and see what is available for all newcomers and immigrants to Brampton. Brampton also has a welcome guide, and this welcome guide gives you information from transportation all the way to health services. That is a wide range of information that is just there available for you to look over so you know exactly what is available in this city for you. You also want to connect with local communities or organizations that have resources available for you. There are so many things just online that can help you in this process of smoothly transitioning into a new city. Navigating the relocation process can be super stressful, and there are other resources there available that can help you as well. Doesn't matter if you're buying or if you're renting, a real estate agent like myself has so many resources that can help you find the property that can fit you perfectly. I do this job every single day of my life, and the knowledge I have, I love to share. So I want to be able to provide you with the best information, the best knowledge in this process. It's not easy just going and trying to find a property yourself if you're renting or if you're buying. So I want to be able to help you through that entire process. And guess what? Buyers and tenants don't pay for my fees. It comes from the seller or the landlord. So you get my services for free. You have someone there right in your corner guiding you through every step of this process, making sure that you are protected through this entire process. So there is no reason you don't want to use someone like me. And then when you're finally here, you want to explore our beautiful city. We are known to be super diverse and unique for everybody in their own lifestyle. Take the time to visit our beautiful neighborhoods, our different parks. There are so many things always going on in our city. Downtown Brampton, Gage Park, you want to walk around that area. We have events in the summer that are absolutely beautiful. We also have our market downtown during the summer. We have so many things. Our city really tries to liven up the area by having so many different events all throughout the summer. And you want to check out this video right here. It tells you 5 reasons why you want to move to Brampton, Ontario. I break down so many different events and different things that are amazing about this city that you don't want to miss. But exploring this city firsthand is one of the best things you can do because you really get to understand what this city is all about and you get to see so many different multicultural things that we have right here for you. I hope this video gave you some insight on how to make your move stress-free. That's what I'm trying to do here, trying to give you as much free knowledge and free information so that when you are thinking about moving to a city or our city, you have the guidance of knowing what you should do prior to moving, as well as what you do when you get here. Thank you so much for taking the time to watch this video. And if you liked the information I provided, please go ahead and subscribe to my channel. Go ahead and like this video, and we will see you guys all next week.